Hi. Mad Magazine has a section all the time. It's called Scenes I'd Like to See. And they draw a cartoon of some improbable event and they kind of make it funny. And then thinking of that and inspired by that and by the theme, Illuminating the Next Decade, this is a leadership speech I'd like to give sometime within the next 10 years. And it takes place at a new parent orientation. I'm the school leader saying, welcome, parents, to your new international school. You're gonna love it here. And we're gonna start with a story about dog racing. In dog racing, there's this mechanical arm that holds a mechanical rabbit, and when the dogs are released, that arm swings around and the dogs chase it. And in this story, there's this dog that won all the races. It was the fastest dog around. And it kept winning all the races until one day, it stopped winning the races. And it looked uninterested and lethargic and kind of depressed, and it would lose race after race, giving half effort. And the other dogs, they grew worried about their friend. And in stories like this, dogs talk. So the dogs went to that fast dog, and they said, what's going on? You used to win all the time. Now you look kind of sad. You're not giving your full effort. What's happening? And the fast dog, the champion dog, said, well, you know that rabbit we've been chasing? I just realized it's not real. And that story scares us because we don't want to have students that chase after great grades and then chase after admission to a prestigious university, chases after the great job, pursues the promotion, buys a big house, buys a fancy car, buys a bigger house, and then might one day wake up feeling empty and asking themselves, have I been chasing a fake rabbit all along? So at these new parent orientations, we always get asked similar questions. And one of the questions we get asked is your school rigorous? Rigorous. This is straight from Google. There's not a lot there that's actually very attractive. Is our school rigorous? I hope not. And I can't guarantee it, but certainly, I hope not. Because at our school, we don't believe in the Listerine approach to education. Listerine did the marketing job of the century. Listerine is a mouthwash that tastes terrible. It's foul. And they somehow convince you that the very fact that it tastes terrible is proof that it's effective. And schools have been doing that to you parents for ages. If your kid is miserable and tired and anxious and stressed out and unhappy, they must be doing some good learning there. We're not like that. We believe in play. Our kids play a lot. And we don't justify their play by saying research shows that it leads to higher levels of academic achievement. Our kids play because play is what kids should do, right? And this is what else we do at our school. We have warm, caring relationships. And we believe in music and art. And even though there's research that says these things lead to higher levels of academic achievement, that's not why we do it. We do it because these are the things that make us human. And even if the research didn't show that it led to higher levels of learning, we would do this anyway. Because not doing this, wouldn't that make us lose a little bit of our humanity? And keep kind of a soft part of your heart for poor music teachers who have to say, hey, take music classes because, you know, it might make your student a better mathematician. And nowhere have I seen that there are more adult mathematicians than there are adult musicians, right? And I was a math teacher, and I know math is beautiful, and math is elegant. But you'd have a hard time convincing me that there are more people who take pleasure in math problems than in music, right? But you never hear a math teacher being forced to say, oh, please take math. It might make your kid a better musician. We do have standardized tests at our school, but only for two reasons. It's because you move a lot. You need some external validation of the learning that your kid has to take to the next school. That's the first reason. And the second reason is because it's another data point so we can meet your kid's needs well. But here's what we don't do. We don't judge ourselves, and we don't want to be judged by standardized test scores. In our school, we don't internally say, you know, last year we had a 92.3% average. Next year, let's go for 92.5%. Let's go then after that for 92.7%. Our school's job we don't think, is to create great test takers. And neither do we want to be judged externally by this. We don't want to be put in a ranking of the best schools in the country or the best schools in a continent or whatever based on these test scores. That's not how we want to be judged, right? I was able to go to a Hewitt school. It's a prestigious girls' school in New York, and I met their school head, and she said it better than I could say it. She said, "We tired of trying to be the best girls' school in New York and instead decided to start focusing on being the best school for our girls." And that's how we want to be. Because, you know, data, it can be dangerous. Haven't you ever noticed that the easiest stuff to measure starts slowly, insidiously, to become the most important thing in your school, the thing that you all talk about? And then that important stuff, the stuff that's hard to measure, sometimes impossible to measure, starts being ignored and cast aside. After all, how do you measure? Respect and decency and love and trust and confidence and safety and care. Those are really hard to measure, but don't fool yourself into thinking they're not important. That's what our school is all about. And we know our school is different, and we're proud of our school. And we're unapologetic for who we are. And please, parents, don't try to change us into something that's familiar to you. But after all, we want the same things you want. We want our kids to be successful. And we want our kids to be happy. And take a moment to think about those two. As you think about your kids and your hopes and dreams for them, would you rather them be successful or happy? Because often it's not the same thing. But that's not all we want for our kids. We want our kids to have lives that matter at our school. We want them to pursue things that are bigger than just themselves. We want them to make a positive impact in the people around them and in the world around them. Because after all, we're educating kids. We're not educating greyhounds. Thank you. That is the scene I'd like to see, and that is the leadership speech I'd like to someday be able to give. Thank you.